In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this euphoric image effect in Photoshop that you can save as a preset and apply it to any image in just one click. Stay tuned and I'll show you how.
Studio Shepherd.
So I have my image open in Photoshop, and this effect works best on darker images, as if it's too bright, then it will just look overexposed. So the first thing that we're going to do is set up an action so we can apply this effect to images once we're finished. So to do this, go up to Window and select Actions. In here, let's click the folder icon, and we can call this whatever you like. I'm going to call it Filters, and then hit OK. And under our Filters folder, click this plus button to create an action, and I'm going to name my action Euphoric Effect, and then hit record. So that is now recording, so we can hide that for now and open up our layers panel. So if our layer is selected, we're going to create a gradient map adjustment and click your gradient bar under basics. We're going to select black and white, and we're going to drag our black slider all the way along until it's around 50 on the location, and drag our white to about there, and we're going to adjust the blending. Then hit OK. And back in layers, we're going to create another adjustment. This time it's going to be curves, and we're going to click on this bar in the middle and drag it up to about here. Maybe a bit more so it's nice and bright. Once you've done that, jump back into layers again, selecting your two adjustment layers and your duplicate. We're going to right click and convert them to a smart object. And we're going to rename this layer to star 1. Press enter and then hit command J to create another duplicate. And this one we're going to rename to star 2. Now let's hide our star 2 layer for now. And with star 1 selected, we're going to go up to filter, down to blur, and select motion blur. I'm going to set the angle to 35 and the distance to around 90 to 100. Looks about right. Then hit OK. And we're going to repeat this step 3 times. So 3 in total. So if you go up to filter, motion blur, hit OK, motion blur, OK. So there should be a total of 3 effects applied. Now we're going to do the same for our star 2 layer, so we can turn this one on and again go up to filter, motion blur, but this time we're going to change the angle to negative 35, hit OK, and apply this 2 more times, so it should look something like this. So now with our star 2 layer selected, I'm going to change the blending mode to lighten. And we're going to select both star 1 and star 2, right click, and convert to a smart object. Now change the blending mode of this layer to screen. And just like that, we've created this star effect. So we can now go up to our actions panel, and we can stop recording. And that's going to save all those steps into one action that we can apply to any image. So I just want to make some final adjustments to this image. So I'm going to select both my star layer and my background, and then I'm going to hit Command J. Right click, and I'm going to convert this to a smart object. And then I'm going to go up to Filter, Blur, Motion Blur. This time we're going to have my angle set to 0, and I'm going to blow it right out so my distance something around 280. Then hit OK. Now I'm going to create a clipping mask from this layer. And with the gradient tool set to black and white, I'm just going to draw within my gradient mask to mask out most of that blur. And you can make adjustments to what looks best. And this is going to help give it this dreamy, distorted effect that we're after. So we can now apply this effect to any image in just one click using the action that we created earlier. So going back right to the start, With our duplicate layer selected, we can go into Actions and we can select our euphoric effect and then simply hit play. And it's going to apply all the steps that we just went through in one click. And that's how to create a euphoric image in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.